There's a fine line between coincidence and irony.
You sure about that map?
Unfortunately, there was some nonsense about the discovery of the real King Arthur's tomb here years ago, soon discredited. And yet another roadside attraction was born.
Well, let's see what we can see, shall we? At least it should be educational. Either housekeeping should be fired, or no one's been inside for months. This place has seen better days.
It's been condemned since the death of the owner, one Professor Worth. I shudder to think that at one time he had students.
They must be electric. I'll have to find the power main.
The place is locked up pretty tight on the ground floor. Probably have to try up higher.
And we have power. There's no difference between stupid and charming with you, is there? Now, Zip, that was too easy. Metaphor, you know. Roman fascist that Alistair believes the whole legend was built around. This is where the truth behind the myth is supposed to be explained, and it's been turned into a warehouse.
Fitting. There's been so little truth everywhere else, why start here? The only factual basis behind the King Arthur myths died centuries before this place was built.
Give Professor Worth some credit. If he had to close the exhibit for renovations, at least he picked the most boring one. This must be our kindly professor's office space.
Dunlap's spottily is his reputation.
Said the pot to the kettle. Professor Worth says here that the tomb of King Arthur, the one his museum's built over, is a fake.
No surprise there. At least he knows his museum is for tourists.
But Professor Worth believed the sarcophagus was placed here by Arthur's contemporaries to lure thieves from the gravesite of the actual King Arthur.
Who doesn't exist?
That's where you and the Professor differ. Tombs in my life to know when I'm looking at a cenotaph.
Say who?
A diversion. This place is trying too hard. It's hiding something.
A body?
No, that's the problem. Please, Alistair. This will take some concentration.
Yeah, pipe down, Alistair. Or I won't let you sit up front with me anymore.
So am I.
That doesn't mean you don't have to be quiet anymore.
Your answer, Alistair.
Wow. You know you're gonna ruin your boots.
Not on the path I'm on. Way up and over.
Disposal.
I hope you're not leaping through there, Laura. There must be a way to stop them up.
I certainly certainly hope so. Might have been worth trying just to hear you lads squeal about it.
you head on down there and stand on that plate for her.
Why don't you go down and hold that door open? Shelf over there? You could use that on the pressure plate.
It's not a crate, it's a coffin. Someone's revered ancestor is in there.
Through having fun, it's time to get back to business. Will you look at that? Oh, this is brilliant.
That is interesting.
Figure that became legend. The once and future king was as real then as the air I'm breathing now.
I don't know, Laura.
Excalibur. Sword in stone. That's how it always goes, isn't it?
Pardon?
Swords in stones, Alistair. They're part of the monomyth. There wasn't just one Excalibur or one Merlin. We keep seeing swords and daises all over the world because they were everywhere.
So you're saying that everywhere they went, they raised up kings, shaping the course of human destiny?
Well, it's a possibility.
Who? And what happened to them and their swords?
Perhaps they're in Avalon. It's as good a place as any. Except our Merlin was killed and our Excalibur was left in pieces in the hands of the locals.
So where's Avalon?
I don't know. On the other side of the looking glass, perhaps?
Thank you.
says Bedivere returned a fragment of Excalibur to Arthur after the other pieces were carried off by the knights.
Where did they go?
To find Avalon, perhaps. The quest for the Holy Grail. Lancelot, Galahad, Percival, and Bors. Their tombs are empty.
It says this fragment was left with Arthur to help him leave this mausoleum when the time came. Perhaps it will help me instead.
anything?
Take the shot!
I told you!
We'll be right back.
I'm fine. Just not my usual evening routine.
Then let's go home.
Brilliant. This is brilliant. King Arthur was real. The Knights of the Round Table were real. And now we have Excalibur right here in front of us. Those stodgy bastards at Oxford will have kittens when they hear of this.
It's even bigger than that, Alistair. What Arthur called Excalibur is a powerful artifact that predates him by millennia.
Well, it's still in pieces. Who brought the superglue?
While I was in Ghana, I asked you to look around for the Galali key. No luck, I take it?
It was not among your father's collection.
Or his records.
It wasn't in Ghana either. Or Rutland was... Hello? What's this? I've seen you before, haven't I? Hang on. Striking resemblance, don't you think?
The pendant was a gift from your father. I never knew from where he had obtained it until now.
Where is it now?
It's in the Himalayas. My mother had it with her. Zip, Alistair, I'm going to Nepal. Please make the usual arrangements.
We'll take care of it. Come on, man.
Not to presume, Lady Croft, but I'd hoped you wouldn't try to use the sword yourself after what happened to your mother.
She removed the sword. That's what killed her. I don't intend to do the same. If my father had known any of this, he tried so hard, and they hated him for it.
No one hated him, Lara.
It bloody well wasn't love, was it? His reputation was destroyed. Now there's more than one thing to be salvaged from that mountaintop.